Yo, what's going on, everybody? This is Two Clutch Gaming here, and today I'm back with episode 6 of my St. Louis Cardinals franchise here on MLB 14 The Show. As you can take a look at the standings, we are currently 5 games under 500 and 6.5 games out of first place of the NL Central. And right now, as you can take a look at the wild card, we are even worse back there as we are 7 games out of the second wild card spot. But we're taking on the Pittsburgh Pirates here in this NL Central rivalry. As Gregory Blanco, the rookie for Pittsburgh, has been batting .211. And this Pedro Alvarez is batting .191. So this Pittsburgh team has done very well so far this season. They're 5 games over 500. And currently we're 5 games under 500. So we're looking to capitalize here. We'll have Shelby Miller on the hill as we're going to be facing off against Gerrit Cole here in this matchup here tonight. So as you can take a look at the series recap so far, a 10-1 victory for the Pirates in game 1, and then the Pirates have won by 3 in the past 2 games, so we don't want to get swept here in a 4-game set, as we want to at least take 1. And so here you can see the lineup for the Pirates. Jordy Mercer batting .314, but Pedro Alvarez is batting .191, and we're in the middle of, I believe, July. So, as you can check out our lineup, Alan Craig and Yadier Molina both batting over .300. Johnny Peralta's getting the day off today, so Daniel Descalzo will be starting in his spot. But we have Shelby Miller on the hill, as I've said before. He's 6-7 on the season with a 4.959 ERA and 104 innings pitched with 88 strikeouts. So 0-2 count here to Gregory Blanco, as I talked about earlier in the episode, as he's going to strike out swinging on a cutter right there. And so that's now going to bring up Gerrit Cole here, who's going to be on the mound for Pittsburgh, who's 7-3 on the season, having a very solid year in 116 and 2/3 innings pitch. So 3-2 count with 2 outs here to Alan Craig, and he's going to swing at it, and he's going to hit one deep in the left center field. This one's gone, not going to stay in, is going to stay in the ballpark, as he's going to get in there with a 2-out double. And so next batter would be Justin Smoke, and he has a 2-2 count with 2 away, and he's going to take this one the other way down the left field line. This one is going to go all the way to the wall, as Craig is going to score, and Justin Smoke is going to get in the second standing up, as he has a 2-out double. So, 0-2 count to Molina. He hits one deep into right center field. This one's hit it for the Cardinal bullpen, and gone. A solo shot, a 2-run shot, I should say, for Yadier Molina. And that is number 100 of his career. Congratulations, Yadi. You've earned it. Just a great way to start to a good milestone in his career, as he hits out number 100 of his career. And the Cardinals lead a 3-0. Here in the first. So 1-2 count with 2 away here to Kyle Seager, and he's going to hit one the other way in the left field for a 2-out and base knock. So that's 4 straight hits for the Cardinals, but with an 0-2 count here to Daniel Descalzo, he's just going to strike out on a curveball in the dirt, and that is going to end the rally. So 0-1 count here to Russell Martin with 2 away in the top half of the second inning. He's going to hit this one into right field, and under it is, I believe, yeah, Alan Craig. He's going to make the catch. So a 1-2 count to Randall Grichuk, who's going to strike out swinging. And the reason that he's starting is because Matt Holliday is currently on the DL. I believe he's going to be maybe out till probably mid-August. But Matt Carpenter is going to rip one into right center field. This one all the way to the warning track dirt. And he's going to get in the second standing up once again. So doubles power so far here in this game for St. Louis. So Oscar Tavares, he just gets an inside pitch and he'll jam it, and it'll be in the center field, and that's going to be caught by McCutcheon, and that will end the inning. So with the 0-2 count here to Gerrit Cole, and this is going to be 9 up and 9 down for Shelby Miller, as he's retired his first 9 batters he's faced. So with a 3-1 count here in the bottom of the third to Alan Craig, he is going to take that pitch down low in the dirt for ball 4, and so we have a leadoff base runner here in the bottom of the third. So with an 0-1 count here to Justin Smoke, he hits a curveball, and he hits the other way for a base hit. So we have 2 runners on with nobody out. So here's Yadier Molina with an 0-1 count. He'll run back up the middle. Diving play by Mercer. Throws on the second for 1 on the first. Double play. As that pretty much killed all of our rally. And then this, as Kyle Seager will hit one pretty fairly deep to center field at the warning track, as McCutcheon to make the catch. So no runs come across in this inning. So with a 1-2 count, Shelby Miller will freeze Russell Martin on that 12-6 curve, as that will end that inning. And Shelby Miller still has not given up a hit so far in this game. So Oscar Tavares with a 1-2 count here in the bottom half of the fifth with 1 away. And once again, doubles power, as Oscar Tavares will get in the second base with a stand-up double. So with a 1-2 count to Alan Craig, he's going to go fishing for that curveball in the outside part of the plate. And so 3-0 count here to Justin Smoke. I don't know why I swung at that pitch. Even though it was up and in the zone, I could have just taken a pitch and waited for a better pitch to hit, as he's going to line out to Starling Marte. And here it is, the first hit for Pittsburgh here on the night. And this is where Shelby Miller would start to struggle. So he has the bases loaded with still nobody out, and Starling Marte is going to hit one deep to right field, and Craig on a late dive, and that is going to bring in every runner on, as that's going to be a bases clearing triple for Starling Marte, as this game is now tied up, as Shelby Miller was just fantastic early. He has now given up 3 runs and make that 4. And the Pirates would have the lead, and they would never look back. So they're up 4-3 now. And so now 2-1 and nobody out still for Pedro Alvarez. He'll ground one through the right side in for a base hit. Coming around is Gregory Polanco. A strong throw from Craig, but it's not in time. So it's now 5-3 Pittsburgh with now 1 away as Russell Martin hits one deep to left field. This one's going to one-hop the wall. And this is when Shelby Miller would eventually get pulled out of the game. As throw home is pretty close, not in time. And so it is now a 7-3 ball game. And no, they're still not done. This one hit to left center field. This one will get down to the gap, all the way into the wall. And an 8-run inning for Pittsburgh gives them an 8-3 lead. Here the ad. And here in the bottom, or top half of the sixth, let's just say. So with a 2-2 count, Starling Marte is going to line one to Descalzo, and that'll end the inning. So speaking of Daniel Descalzo, he has a 2-0 count. He will rip one deep to right field, not known for his power, more of a contact hitter, as he hits one into right for a base hit, and this one's going to be a stand-up double for Daniel Descalzo. So 1-2 count with 2 outs to Randall Grichuk. He had about a 9-pitch at-bat. But he will strike out. So here's your 7-8 line score. Just that big 8. The big 8 spot. And they're in the 6th inning for the Pittsburgh Pirates. As they lead it 8-3 here on the top of the 7th. So first pitch here from Tyler Lyons to Gregory Polanco. He'll hit one deep to left center field. Going back is Oscar Tavares, as that will hop over the wall. So with a 2-0 count, Pedro Alvarez will come. He will ground out. And I went home with that throw. I really thought he was out, but the umpire calls him safe. And then Russell Martin, 2 batters later, will hit one into right field, and Alan Craig will make the catch. So 9-7 here in the top half of the 7th inning. Oscar Tavares will get things started with a line shot in the center for a base hit. And very next pitch, and Alan Craig, he's still on fire. He's going to hit one deep to left field, and this one is way out of here over the bullpen for Alan Craig. And the Cardinals now go in within 4. So Justin Smoke is up. He will line one left center field. This one will drop in for a hit. And so now a rally starting here with 2 away for the Cardinals, as Yadier Molina will shoot one in the center field for a hit. And now 2-1 with 2 out now for St. Louis. And so the bases are loaded for Daniel Descalzo. Hits one deep to right center field, but this one will die out in center, as that could have possibly tied up the game for us. So Alan Hansen, the pinch hitter, is up, and he'll strike out on a cutter from Jason Mott. And so top of the 9th inning here, 1-2 count to Starling Marte, and he's going to strike out swinging on that fastball. And so 2-0 count now to Pedro Alvarez, and this was just a hanging slider. And he's going to crush one deep to right field, and this one's over the Cardinal bullpen. So Pedro Alvarez hits home run number 98 of his career, and the Pittsburgh Pirates now are in double digits as they lead it 11-5. As I said earlier, when they scored that 8-run inning in the 6th, they just never looked bad. They even added on to their lead, as they have now scored 3 runs after that inning. So it's an 11-5 game, and Neil Walker will just slowly tap one right back to Rosenthal, and he will throw on to first for the out. So 2 outs in the inning. Justin Smoke is up with a 1-1 count. Here's the pitch, and he's just going to pop this one up to Russell Martin behind the plate, and he's going to make the catch, and that will end the ball game. So the Cardinals were up 3-0 going to the top of the 6th inning. They gave up 8 runs, and well, they gave up 11 runs, but only scored 2. So the Pirates win this one 11-5. As we had the Pirates had 11 runs on 13 hits, we had 5 runs on 12 hits. Pedro Alvarez had a 2-run shot to give number 12 on the season, as Alan Craig also added on to, as he had 2 home runs in this game. So thank you all for watching.